So it looks like Hitman 3 will be able to play all the old Hitman levels coming soon. But this begs a bigger question. What happens when you buy games from different storefronts on one single platform like PC? Let's find out. So today we find out from IGN that Hitman 3 PC players will be able to play Hitman 1 and 2 levels for free if they own them. Now, if you haven't heard about this, Hitman 3 is releasing today, but on a Twitter post by IO Interactive on Twitter, they stated that we are continuing to work on a solution with our partners to allow PC players who own Hitman 1 or Hitman 2 to import locations from those games into Hitman 3 at no additional cost. We guarantee that players will not need to repurchase the games. Until we roll that out in the coming weeks, the Hitman 1 Game of the Year Access Pass will be free to own for all PC players who pre-purchase or purchase Hitman 3 in the first 10 games after release. This is on the Epic storefront, by the way. We're excited for you to enjoy the full roll of assassination experience. Thank you from IO Interactive. Now, this tweet was made on the 17th, as we see here. Now, the issue that we're seeing is that if you are going to purchase Hitman 3 day one on the Epic Store, you will not have access to the levels from which you purchased on Steam or any other storefront. This is pretty much insane to me. Where you buy a game should not determine if you're able to actually play that game on your platform first and foremost. That's kind of silly. That's like buying a stereo from Circuit City, I'm just going to age myself here, and then buying an amp or a DAC from Best Buy, and then not being able to use those two things together, even though they're from the same company and they're part of the same manufacturer because you bought them at different stores. That's how ridiculous this actually looks and sounds. But thankfully, we had an update today, actually the same day on the 17th as well. And this article is by Adam Bunkhurst, and he says, those who own Hitman and Hitman 2 on PC will be able to import their locations in Hitman 3 for free, although not at launch. IO Interactive announced the news on Twitter and revealed that even though the import feature won't be available on January 20th, when the PC purchase launches exclusively on the Epic Games Store, well, that could be a whole other conversation we'll have as well. The Hitman 1 Game of the Year Access Pass will be free to all players who pre-purchase or purchase Hitman 3 in the first 10 days, like we talked about. So IO Interactive assures that players will not need to repurchase the older games and that the import feature will be available in the coming weeks. So here's my thing about that. If the import feature will be available in the coming weeks, why wasn't it put in from the very beginning? What stopped IO Interactive from actually allowing people to import their older games into Hitman 3? And if your response is, well, the Epic Store or Steam or whatever the case, you're missing out the entire point of why people game on PC. The Epic Game Store, Steam, GOG, those are not platforms. They're not a platform on PC. PC is the platform. Those individual things are storefronts. Where you buy the game should not determine whether or not you can actually play that game on your platform, or even have content from previous games that are designed to have that content be based across all those other iterations available to you. Like, that's the real issue. What is causing that break between, oh, a specific storefront has it? Well, you could argue that Steam is a DRM, and in fact, yes, it is. So is the Epic Game Store. This goes back to why I've always believed that GOG and or piracy is really the only way for you to keep your games, because of the fact there's too many people meddling in your things and they think they own the product that you purchased, which in fact they don't. So let's continue this, shall we? As of writing, only Hitman and Hitman 3 are available for purchase, pre-purchase on the Epic Games Store, and there is currently no way to show that you purchased Hitman 2 from another store. As detailed in Hitman 3 pre-launch guide, players will be able to carry over their progression from Hitman 2 at launch through a web browser. While that process hasn't been detailed yet, it will require an IOI account. So for those who do not own a previous version of Hitman and wish to play the previous levels in Hitman 3, The access pass for both Hitman and Hitman 2 will be available for purchase. Furthermore, there will be an 80% discount on the access pass in the Epic Game Store for the first 14 days after launch. So that's at least something they're being thrown a bone at for that specific thing. But this still goes back to my original process, right? If IO Interactive are guaranteeing that there will not be a necessity or a reason for you to actually buy those games again, why wasn't this feature implemented in the first place? I mean, clearly they had to have known that this is something that would happen, but apparently not, because this whole thing didn't get recognized until there was a backlash on Twitter about the fact that they could not port over their previous data from those prior games. Now, if you're looking at FSAPO Jake, which you should totally follow his YouTube and Twitter account, he says, so a fix was found one whole day after the backlash. If this ain't proof that you and Epic did this intentionally and wanted to see what you can get away with, I don't know what is. And I'm inclined to agree with that, mostly because this whole thing did not come into light until the backlash actually came into place. And honestly, anything like this really is a shady practice. Now, I'm not going to sit here and blame Epic totally on this. That doesn't make any sense. IO Interactive does also take the blame, because this should have been seen as something in the forefront, as a forethought. If we're going to be exclusive to Epic, we need to figure out what's going to be happening. Are we making a hard cutoff on Hitman 3? Are we adding all the old content? How will we do that? Will we use an IOI account? How will we carry that progression over, right? So that is what they should have figured out first and foremost before even figuring out what they're going to be doing with the game or in general. But as Jake said, the fact that one day later there's going to be a fix in a few days, that's also another concern as well. So they were hiding this in their back pocket, not really looking into what they're going to be doing, and not really telling us all the full information. So let me know what you guys think in the comment section down below. I honestly think this is sort of like a combination of IO Interactive and Epic trying to do a thing to people. I don't want to, you know, be too vulgar on that. But I am happy, though, that IO Interactive is going to be doing something to fix that issue. And then again, as the platform progresses, PC is an open platform with multiple storefronts. Whether I buy my game on, you know, McFluffer Truffle's gaming site shouldn't matter. What should matter is the fact that I own a copy of that game and I should be able to play it if that game requires the other previous games or carries over progression from those games. The files should be found. They should be there. It should automatically tick in. There's really no reason why this should be an issue. So let me know what you guys think in the comment section down below. Let me know what you think about this whole thing. And also, buyer beware if you're expecting to pick this up day one on the Epic Game Store. Follow me on Twitch and Twitter, and I'll see you guys next time. Have a good one.